Hello everybody, Adam W. Warner here. In today's video we're going to try out the new WordPress.com desktop app that lets you connect and manage your WordPress.com sites and Jetpack enabled WordPress.org self-hosted sites all in one place. So this is the app for the Mac. I'm going to go ahead and go through the install process here. I've already downloaded it, so I'm going to drag it to my applications folder. And in this video I'll be connecting to a WordPress.org self-hosted site that uses the Jetpack plugin in order to connect to my WordPress.com account and the WordPress REST API. Okay, so it is installed. Let's go ahead and open up my applications folder. And we go down here to the WordPress.com app. I'm going to go ahead and double-click that. And that's going to open up down here in my dock. I'm going to right-click that. And we're going to go ahead and open it. I'm going to right-click that app icon. I'm going to choose to keep it in my dock. So now I need to connect to WordPress.com, I believe. Well, let's try a self-hosted site. Okay, that's bringing me to a tutorial on how to do that. So let me go ahead. Alright, so we're restarted here. I'm going to go ahead and log into my WordPress.com account. Okay, now I'm connected. You can see it defaults to the reader view. So it's going to show me some WordPress sites that I'm already subscribed to, so I can go ahead and read in there. It's a nice interface. I'm going to go ahead to My Sites. You can see I've got a really old site here. No activity, blog posts, sharing. So let's go ahead and let's connect to a self-hosted site. So first thing I want to do is go to Succeed with WP because I have not yet installed or activated Jetpack. Go ahead and log in here. And the reason I'm doing this is because this site is not yet listed in my list of sites. So let's go ahead and go to Installed Plugins. And Jetpack is here. I just need to activate that. And then connect to WordPress.com here with Jetpack. Okay, and go ahead and put in my WordPress.com account details here. I'm going to approve that connection. Let's see, my Jetpack connection. Let's go ahead and activate the manage feature. Okay, so I want to view all the active. Okay, manage is active. Boy. So much stuff in Jetpack that is activated by default. Let's go ahead and deactivate everything but manage. Okay, so the only thing that's active is manage. Let's see if we need to activate any sharing or anything like that. I don't think so. Okay, so let's go back to the app. Let's click Manage All My Sites. There it is. Succeed with WP. No post pages, nothing here, not surprising. So what you can do here, and you can see on this site there are no posts yet. And if I wanted to create a post, I could go to Add Blog Post. And now I get a nice little interface here to write my blog posts. So put in a title. You can see you've got the familiar editor here. You can toggle the advanced features. It does an automatic save. Let's put in some default lipsum text. Go ahead and just paste that in there. And let's add an image. Add media. Let's upload some media. I'm going to choose that image. Open it up. Now it looks like you have, there's an image size option here. So I'm not sure, that must use the built-in WordPress media sizes. So I'm going to go ahead and insert that into the post, see what happens here. You can see it's doing the autosave. If I click the image, I get the familiar image tools. I normally like a little more control over my image sizes, and I'm not sure how that's happening here, other than increase or decrease image size. I can add a caption if I like. So this is my caption. All right, let's go ahead and enter a link. This is a link, and I don't want that to be a heading 2. So let's go ahead and select that, choose that to be a paragraph, insert a link here. Open it in a new window. There we go. Okay, it shows a nice word count there. So I like this interface overall. You can switch to HTML if you want. That's nice. The image sizing is one thing I'm not 100% keen on. So it does my default category, which is plugins. I can add a new category. I can add some tags. Let's add the WordPress.com app. Okay, and it enters it as a hashtag there. Featured image, there is not one. So let's set a featured image. Let's choose that one. And it came in sideways. Interesting. Okay, here's the image edit. Oh, there it is. So let's see what happens when we edit the image. Okay, we get the familiar media library image edit screen. Let's go ahead and add a quick caption there. Some alt text. This is the description. Set that featured image. Huh, interesting. You notice it came in sideways and then it showed right side up. Okay. Can do an excerpt for the post. Let's do that. That's for your blog archive page, your category archive page. Let's allow comments. Boy, I'm not really keen on that featured image being sideways. Let's see what that how that looks when we publish. All right. Well, without further ado, let's go ahead and publish. I could schedule, it looks like. So let's publish that to the site. All right, and then let's view the post. It opens up a new window, test post, which is the slug. Okay, we got the image in there, full size. Looks good. Caption's there. Text is there. Link is there. Category. Tags. All looks good. So let's look at the blog archive page and see what that featured image looks like. Ah, yeah, see, sideways. Not too keen on that. All right, so let's see if we can change that in here. All right, so this shows the featured image. I can't click anywhere to edit that image directly. So let's X that out and let's see if we can we? I wonder how that's controlled. Let's try this as the featured image. See what happens there. Now that comes in. I wonder if it if it just depends on the aspect ratio of the image. Okay, so now let's update this post. It's pretty fast. I like it. It's clean. Okay, so the featured image shows in the blog archive page and in the test post. Okay, so that is a quick first-hand run-through of the WordPress.com app for Mac. It looks pretty slick. Again, I can post to any site I want. I can switch sites. I can view my stats, my plan, pages, etc. So far, so good. What do you think?